Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to watch this whole video to gain understanding. Thank you, Brother Salim, for your question. The verse says, try the spirits whether they are of God. Spirits mentioned in plural, so you believe in many holy ghosts? That's the first question. And you say also that Holy Ghost is God, so you believe in many gods? Any Christian can explain? Last video I talked about the verse that confuses Muslims.
Then in the same John, in the first epistle of John, chapter 5, verse 4, he says, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits whether they are of God. For many false prophets have gone out into the world. So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit. True prophet is a true spirit. Saint John is using spirit for a prophet. Don't believe every spirit. Means don't believe in every prophet.
1 John 4:1, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirits, whether they are of God, because many false prophets are gone out into the world. Looking at this verse, Ahmed Deedat wrongly concluded that spirit and prophet are used synonymously. In fact, the two words are different in the Greek and different in correct application. Spirit is pneuma in the Greek. False prophet is pseudo-prophete. The words are different and they are not synonymous. The words are not interchangeable and cannot be used one in place of the other. And the correct understanding of the verse is that the prophet is different than the spirit for whom the prophet speaks. A prophet speaks for a spirit, and the spirit may be said to come on, or rest on, or motivate, or move the prophet. Well, after that video, another Christian brother, nicer person, provided an excellent list of verses that confirm and demonstrate my explanation. Numbers 11:29. But Moses said to him, are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the Lord's people were prophets, that the Lord would put his spirit upon them. So here is Moses, speaking of Yahweh, putting his spirit on the people, making them prophets. 1 Samuel 10:6, then the spirit of the Lord will come upon you mightily, and you shall prophesy. It is the coming upon by the Spirit of the Lord that empowers the prophecy. 1 Samuel 10:10, and when they came thither to the hill, behold, a company of prophets met him, and the Spirit of God came upon him, and he prophesied among them. The Spirit of God came first, as was foretold a few verses earlier. Then the prophet spoke what the Spirit of the Lord inspired. He could not prophesy until the Spirit was on him. 1 Samuel 19:20, and Saul sent messengers to take David, and when they saw the company of the prophets prophesying, the Spirit of God was upon the messengers of Saul, and they also prophesied. 1 Kings 22, and the Lord said unto him, wherewith? And he said, I will go forth, and I will be a lying spirit in the mouth of all his prophets. Now therefore, behold, the Lord hath put a lying spirit in the mouth of all these thy prophets. It is the spirit that exerts influence over the mouth, or the words of the prophet. A false spirit, or a lying spirit, causes the prophet to utter lies and falsehoods. 2 Kings 2:15. Now when the sons of the prophet who were at Jericho opposite him saw him, they said, the spirit of Elijah rests on Elisha. And they came to meet him and bowed themselves to the ground before him. In this usage, the spirit of does not literally mean Elijah's human spirit. Nehemiah 9:30. However, you bore with them for many years, and admonished them by your spirit through your prophets. Yet they would not give ear, Therefore, you gave them into the hand of the peoples of the lands. The Spirit of God spoke through, or using, the prophets. Ezekiel 13:3. Thus saith the Lord God, Woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit, and have seen nothing. This verse does refer to the human spirit of the prophet. It is not referring to a demon or other spirit. And this makes sense when biblical definitions are applied. A human being is a spirit, and the spirit lives in a body. One can become aware of their own spirit through discipline and knowledge. In the previous verse, the prophet had simply learned to hear his own inner hidden man of the heart. But it is only the Bible, which includes the Torah, which can discern the spirit of man. Hebrews 4:12, For the word of God is living and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. It pierces even to dividing soul and spirit, joints and marrow. It is able to judge the thoughts and intentions of the heart. Moving on. Zechariah 13:2, Saith the Lord of hosts, that I will cut off the names of the idols out of the land, and they shall no more be remembered. And also I will cause the prophets and the unclean spirits to pass out of the land. Here, God identifies prophets separately from the unclean spirits. This implies they are independent and different, meaning spirits and prophets are not the same entities. So, brother, from actually examining many references in the Bible, we can see how spirits and prophets are involved and how they interact. The error that Deedat makes is subtle, because Deedat did not respect the Torah and Bible enough to study it for understanding.
So false spirit is a false prophet is a false spirit, true prophet is a true spirit.
Deedat says a false prophet is a false spirit. In fact, a false prophet listens to a false spirit, or is led by a false spirit, or has a false spirit guide. Ultimately, a false prophet speaks for a false spirit. Now, even having said that, in one narrow sense, Deedat is close to correct. Because a prophet is a human being, the prophet is a human spirit. The spirit of a man is clearly mentioned in Scripture. 1 Corinthians 2:11, For who among men knows the things of the man except the spirit of the man within him? So also no one knows the things of God except the spirit of God. The spirit of the man speaks of the human spirit that is the essence of the man. When a man is motivated by his own spirit, he is not a prophet of a spirit, because he speaks for himself. This was mentioned in one of the earlier verses. Ezekiel 13:3, Thus says the Lord God, Woe unto the foolish prophets that follow their own spirit and have seen nothing. If he follows himself, he has seen nothing. But human spirits are not described in the Bible as true spirits or false spirits. And that is one piece of Deedat's error, attempting to twist the word spirit to be replaced by prophet. This is the important information to keep in your mind, brother. Ahmed Deedat, who popularized this argument, had a purpose to achieve. Ahmed Deedat needs to fit Mohammed into the description and references of the Comforter.
He said, look, you say it is the Comforter. Who is the comforter? He said, the comforter is the Holy Ghost. They said, the comforter is the Holy Ghost. So they'll ask you, is Muhammad a ghost? He says, no. So it can't be Muhammad. I said, now what is that Greek word for ghost in your language? Greek word. It's pneuma. Pneuma means spirit. Wherever it suits you, you translate that word, P-N-E-U-M-A, pneuma. A spirit, when it suits you, you translate it as ghost. When you talk about spirit, you can have it fitting Muhammad.
If you allow Deedat to change the word spirit into the word prophet, you can have it fitting Muhammad. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.